Can you see the material?
Yes, ma'am.
So construction of fruit loop, construction of signal flow graphs. So before we start discussing the construction, please write down these equations. The equations are x2 is equal to a12 x1 plus a32 x3 plus a42 x4 plus a52 x5. x3 is equal to a23 into x2. x4 is equal to a34 into x3 plus a44 into x4. And x5 is equal to a35 x3 plus A45 X4. হ্যালো, হ্যাঁ ক্লাস নিচ্ছি, একটা ক্লাস, আচ্ছা আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে। ডান,
ইয়েস ম্যাম।
ওকে, নাও ইউ সি দিস আর দ্য সেট অফ ফোর লিনিয়ার অ্যালজেব্রিক ইকুয়েশনস অ্যান্ড হাউ মেনি ভেরিয়েবলস আর দেয়ার, ফাইভ ভেরিয়েবলস আর দেয়ার, x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5, right? So five variables. So if we consider that these equations actually in the transform domain represents the these equations actually represent the dynamic behavior of the system in the transform domain, right? So that means actually we are getting five signals, five different signals flowing through the system, overall system, which are x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5. Okay, now, so since we do have five signals or five variables, hence the first thing that is to be done is to draw this five small circles, and label them as five signals or five system variables, like x1, the first one, x1, the second one, x2, third one, x3, fourth one, x4, and the fifth one, x5. Do it. Done. Done.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now you see these equations actually represents the relationship amongst the variables x1, x2, x3, x4, x5. Now, since the system is not given, here we assume that x1 is the input node or the source, and x5 is the output node or the sink. So again, I repeat, x1 is the input node, and or we can say x1 is the input to the system, and x5 is the output generated by the system. Now let's focus on the first equation. So the first equation states that x2 is equal to a1 to x1. So this variable x1 this variable x1 is related to x2, and in the process this x2, this particular signal or this particular variable gets multiplied by a factor or by a gain, which is a12. To depict this relation, what we'll do, we'll draw a branch, we'll draw a branch which will connect x2 to x1, and the signal will flow from x1 to x2, and in the process the signal will, the signal x1 will get multiplied by this gain, which is the branch transmittance. In the parlance of signal flow graph, branch transmittance a12. So x2 is equal to what we have discussed so far, that the signal value at any particular node is sum of the signal values, incoming signal values, right? So we have shown one signal value, one signal here with the help of this branch. So x2 is equal to, so far, x2 is equal to a12 into x1. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what is the second component of the equation? A32 into x3. That means x3 will again be related 2x2, and the gain involved is a32. Hence, again at the node x2, we'll have to add another branch which will originate from this particular node depicting the signal x3 or the system variable x3, right? So the branch will start from x3 and will terminate on to x2. Let's try to find out the branch. Yes, this one is the branch. Branch will originate from x3 and will terminate on to x2, and the signal will get multiplied. When the signal will flow in this direction, it will get multiplied by the branch transmittance a32. So whenever you will be drawing this branch, don't forget to put the arrow in the appropriate direction, and don't forget to put the branch transmittance. And as I said, if even if the branch transmittance is one, you will have to write down one over here. Clear? So now x2 is equal to a1 to x1 plus a3 to x3. Clear? So far, is this clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Are you drawing the network? Drawing the graph?
Yes, ma'am. We are drawing.
Okay. Now, the third component is A42 X4. Now, we can apply the same logic. That means we'll have to draw a branch which will originate from this particular node x4 and will terminate onto this particular node x2, and in the process the signal x4 will get multiplied by the gain a42. So this is the, yes, this is the branch we are talking about, x4. The branch has started from this particular node, and this is the branch transmittance a42, and branch has terminated on this node, which is x2. And the last component is A5 to X5. So again, a branch should be incorporated starting from this particular node X5, and the branch will terminate at this particular node X2, and in the process it will get multiplied by the branch transmittance A52. Now let's have a look at that particular equation. Once again, let's focus on the equation. So we know that the signal value at any node is equal to sum of all the incoming signals, right? So X2, if you look at this part of the graph, this portion of the graph, then we get X2 is equal to A1 to X1 plus A3 to X3 plus A4 to X4 plus A5 to X5. And that is our equation. So we have mapped this equation into a portion of signal flow graph. Now, the next equation is x3 is equal to A23 into x2. That means this signal will have to incorporate a branch which will start from x2 and which will start from x2 and will terminate onto x3. And in the process, the signal will get multiplied by A23. So let's see. So this is the branch which is starting from X2 and terminating at X3. And this is the branch transmittance. And the value of X3 is simply A23 into X2. So one single branch will be there which will connect this signal X2 to the signal X3. Now the next equation, x4 is equal to a34 into x3 plus a44 into x4. That means x4 is a function of x3 and x4 itself. X4 depends on its own value. Own value. So let's translate this equation into a signal flow graph. So X4 will be connected to X3, and the branch transmitters, the signal will flow in this particular direction as X4 is equal to A34 into X3. So the signal will flow from X3 to X4, and in the process will get multiplied by this gain, which is A34, which is the branch transmittance. And X4 depends on its own value. That's why in this network, in this graph, we'll get a self loop. This is called a self loop. This is called a self loop, and the gain value of the self loop is A44. So the value of X4, if you apply the knowledge of signal flow graph, then the value of X4 will be A34 into X3 and A44 into X4, and that is exactly the equation that we have. Done. Have you understood? So far, is this clear?
यस मैम।
एंड व्हाट इज द लास्ट इक्वेशन? द लास्ट इक्वेशन इज x5 इज इक्वल टू a35 इनटू x3 प्लस a45 इनटू x4. दैट मींस वन ब्रांच शुड स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर नोड x3 एंड द सेकेंड ब्रांच विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस नोड x4. So x5 is equal to this branch a45 into x3, and this is the direction of signal flow, plus x3 into a35. So x5 is equal to a45 into x4 plus a35 into x3, and these are the directions of signal flow. Right? So we have mapped all the equations in the form of graph. Now we can combine all this. We can combine all this. That means to get the complete graph, now we'll have to add this particular branch. So we'll add the branch over here along with the branch direction as well as the branch transmittance. Next, we'll connect, we'll add this portion. And so x3 will be connected to x4, and the signal will flow from x3 to x4, and the branch gain will be a34, and there will be a self loop like this. Okay, and then the last portion, this portion, so x5 will be connected to x4, and the branch signal will flow from x4 to x5. And the branch transmittance will be A45, and another branch will be there, which is this one, from X3 to X5, and the branch gain will be A35. So this is our complete signal flow graph, which represents the set of four linear algebraic equations. Have you drawn this? The complete signal flow graph?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now we have assumed that X1 is the input node, and that is clear, or the source, that is clear from this particular graph. As you see, this particular node has only outgoing branch, one single outgoing branch, and this particular node doesn't have any incoming branch. So that's why we can easily identify this node to be the input node or the source. But X5, look at this particular node, it has got both incoming as well as outgoing branches, right? So X5 cannot be identified quite easily as the output node. So what can be done? We can add one branch with a branch gain unity, and we can show the sixth node. The signal value of the sixth node will be same as this fifth node. So the signal value or the system variable will be X5. So that means now our task is to find out the transfer function of the system for which we have drawn this signal flow graph. That means we'll have to find out the gain between x5 and x1. And that is actually the transfer function of the system. Now, Mason's gain formula. So the relationship between an input variable and an output variable of a signal flow graph is given by the net gain between the input and the output nodes and is known as the overall gain of the system. Mason's gain formula for the determination of the overall system gain is given by T. This is the overall gain between the output and the input variable, or in other words, T stands for the closed loop transfer function of the system, is given by is equal to 1 by delta summation of pk into delta k, where the variable is k. It's written R, isn't it? এখানে আর লেখা তো ভেরিয়েবলটা,
Yes, ma'am.
That is incorrect. Please correct it. Pk delta k. So it's apparent that the variable will be k over here. So T will be equal to 1 by delta summation over k Pk into delta k. Now, what is Pk? Pk is the kth forward path gain. Or in other words, path gain of the kth forward path, right? So if we have, say, three forward paths, one, two, three, then P1 will be the path gain of the first forward path. P2 will be the path gain of the second forward path. P3 will be the path gain of the third forward path. So if you have k number of forward paths, then will have path gains like P1, P2, P3, etc. up to Pk. Okay. Now, I'll come to delta k. First, let me explain what is delta. Delta is the delta is called the determinant of the graph, of the complete graph, determinant of the graph. And how we can calculate delta? For that, also we have a formula. Delta is equal to 1 minus summation of, okay, let's come over here. Delta, that is determinant of the graph, is equal to 1 minus sum of loop gains of all individual loops. So suppose you have got three loops, L1, L2, L3. For L1, you find the loop gain. You write down the loop gain, put a plus sign. Put a plus sign. Then for second loop, L2, find out the loop gain. Put there. So loop gain of first loop plus loop gain of second loop plus loop gain of third loop, so and so forth. Okay, so sum of loop gains of all individual loops. So we are considering one single loop at one point of time. Next, plus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops. Already we have discussed the definition of non-touching loops. That means two loops will be called to be non-touching if they do not possess any common node, if they do not have any common node. So in a signal flow graph, if you can identify two non-touching loops, then you'll have to find out the loop gain of the first loop, loop gain of the second loop, which is a non-touching loop with respect to the first one. Then you'll have to multiply the loop gains or those two loop gains. Right. And in your graph, if you have m such combinations of two non-touching loops, then you will have to repeat this procedure and you'll have to sum up all the product gains, right? That means we are considering two non-touching loops at a time, and we are multiplying their loop gains, and then we are adding, we are considering the second. Then you'll have to consider the second combination, and you'll have to repeat the procedure. Minus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of three non-touching loops. That means three loops will be said to be non-touching if they do not possess any common node. So in this case, you'll have to consider three loops at one point of time, and you'll have to perform the, you'll have to calculate the product of the loop gains of all three non-touching, or product of the gains of the all three non-touching loops, all possible combinations, right? And the next term will be sum of gain products of all possible combinations of four non-touching loops, so and so forth. And the plus and minus sign will alternate. One minus sum of loop gains of all individual loops, then plus, then the sign will be minus, then again the sign will be plus, right? So this can be written in a compact form in this way. So one delta is equal to one minus summation of PM1, M combinations of single loops, individual loops. One stands for one single loop, that means individual loop. So sum of loop gains of individual loops, all individual loops, plus summation over M PM2. M possible combinations of two non-touching loops, right? In this case, we'll not consider any two loops, only we'll have to consider two non-touching loops if present in the signal flow graph. Then minus summation of gain product of M possible combinations of three non-touching loops, and this will continue. Right, so PMR is the gain product of mth possible combination of r non-touching loops. So that is the determinant of the graph. So what is delta k? Delta k is the determinant of that particular portion of the graph which does not touch the kth forward path. That's why it's written as delta k. I repeat, delta k is the determinant of that portion of the graph, only that portion of the graph which does not touch the kth forward path. So since it's the determinant of a portion of the graph, hence the value of delta k can be computed using this particular formula. But you'll have to remember that the portion of the graph for which you are finding out the determinant should not touch the kth forward path. Do you have any question? Please go through this part and find out whether you have understood this or not. And obviously, it will be clear when we'll be discussing this example. Understood? Have you understood the formula?
यस मैम।
ओके, सो नाउ यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, दिस इज नोन एज मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला. नाउ यूजिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मूला विल ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द gain of this graph, that means the ratio x5 by x1. So look at this graph. First of all, we'll have to identify the forward paths. So try to identify the forward paths. How many forward paths are there in this particular graph? Forward path means a path which connects the output node directly to the input node. So, how many forward paths are there in this graph?
Two men.
Two.
Yes.
So, which are the forward paths? Just tell me the name of the nodes or signal values at the nodes.
A1 2, A2 3,
No,
A3.
no, 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 no.
Achha, okay ma'am.
A1 2 is the branch transmittance. So whenever you'll be identifying a path or a loop, it has to be in terms of the nodes. Clear?
ओके मैम, X1, X2, X3, X4, X5, सो
Yes.
दिस इज़ द वन, एंड
The second
अनदर
one.
वन, एंड द सेकेंड वन इज़ द X1, एंड देन X2,
Yes.
एंड देन से X3,
Right.
एंड देन X5.
X5. X5. Right. So the first forward path is P1 is X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. Now we'll have to find out the path gain. So for the first forward path, the path gain is P1, the path gain is A1 2 into A2 3 into A3 4 into A4 5, right? So we have defined PK to be the path gain of kth forward path. So the path gain, that means product of all the branch transmittances appearing in the first forward path, that is P1, will be equal to A1 2 into A2 3 into A3 4 into A4 5. Right? So please write down P1 is equal to A1 2, A2 3, A3 4, A4 5. And for the second forward path, P2, path gain of the second forward path, P2 will be equal to A1 2 into A2 3 into A3 5. Done? That's it.
Done, ma'am.
So can we proceed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now you tell me why we are not considering this to be a forward path as well? X1 to X2 to X3 to X4, then again X4, and then X5. This would be, we are moving along the direction of branch
Yes,
loop. Yes.
that will be a self loop, so we will not consider.
No, that is not the basic reason. Yes, it's a self loop by you, but why we can't consider this to be our path? Because you see, we are traversing this node x2 twice, isn't it? Which is not allowed. Is it clear? What was the definition of a path? It is the traversal of connected branches in the direction of branch arrows such that no node is traversed more than once. Clear? So, if we move in this particular direction to this particular node X5, that means we are traversing this node twice, which is not permitted. Am I clear? So that's why this cannot be, this connected branches cannot be considered to be a path. Have you clearly understood this? Yes or no? Okay. Now, our next task is to identify all the loops. After that, we'll try to find out whether some of the loops are non-touching in nature or not. But first, identify all the loops present in this particular graph. So, how many loops are there in this graph?
Five, ma'am.
Sure. So, identify the loops. Let's see
Four.
whether it's four or five. Let's see. Just start identifying the loops one by one. Tell me the nodes, and I'll follow your
In
command.
X2, X3,
Huh?
X2 to X3, and then it will be the return path. X2 and X3. It will be one.
X2, X3, then X2. We are
X2.
not traversing this, right? We are terminating on this particular node. So
Ma'am.
X2, X3
X2,
to
X3, X2.
X2.
Yeah.
So write down L1 to be X2, X3. We are finding out the loop gains. Yeah. Just identify the loop. So L1 is X2, X3, X2. The second loop.
It will be X2, X3, X4,
X2.
X2 then again.
X2, that means this one,
Yes,
right?
please.
So X2, X3, X4, then X2. Okay, this is our loop number two. Loop number three.
X2, X3, X4, X5, then X2.
X2, X3, X4,
X5,
X5,
then X2.
then X2. Yes, certainly it's a loop. So, is this the third loop? Is it L3 or L4?
L3.
L3. So L3 is our X2, X3, X5, and then X2. Fourth loop. Is there any fourth loop in this graph?
Yes, ma'am. X3, X4, X5, X3.
x3
x4 x5
x4
x4 x5 x3 again.
x3
Yes ma'am, this one.
we have not considered this loop so far.
No ma'am.
No, not yet.
Not yet. Okay, fine. Then it's right. It's a loop x3, x4, x5, then x3. So this is loop number 5.
And there should be more loops which will involve some parts of the previous loops.
For example,
ma'am, x2, x3, x5.
X2, x3.
X5.
X5. Okay, next. Then?
Oh, no, no, sorry, ma'am. I mistook the direction.
So you considered this path? Have you considered this path? Yes or no?
Yeah, no, ma'am. I did not see the return path. I thought that was
okay.
In the opposite.
Anyway, direction. You cannot traverse against the direction of branch arrow. And is there any fifth loop?
Ma'am, if A44 is not unity, then that loop can be considered.
X4 to X4, that will be a loop.
Even if A44 is unity,
then
already
it will be.
Already I've used the term. Already I've used the term. It's a self loop.
Hmm.
Yes, it's a loop. Because this path is originating from this particular node and is terminating, or I should move in this direction, and is terminating at this particular node. So it's a self loop. So it is a loop. So that
and then when we will be means writing the loops, we have to mention that A44 should not be unity.
No, no. I haven't said that. What did I say? Even A44 is unity, then also it will be considered to be a self loop.
Then it will not be an invalid loop.
Why?
According to that Mason-Gain's formula, that a self-sustaining loop of unity gain is an invalid loop.
For the time being, you assume A44 to be any arbitrary number, any arbitrary number, any arbitrary real number, right? So now we'll have to find out the loop gains. So P11, let's write P11. That means, or you can write L11 as well to differentiate between the path gain and the loop gain. So first we'll have to find out individual loop gains. So L11 or P11, that was our first loop. Okay. So it will be A23 into A32. Likewise, I don't know what is the number of this loop, whether it was L2 or L3. Anyway, just note the loop gain for this individual loop is given by A34 into A45 into this one. This is not a loop, sorry. Okay, this one. So A23 into A34 into A43. So please note down all the individual loop gains for all the 5 loops that we have identified to be present in this signal flow graph. Done.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so we have identified all the individual loops. Now, next task is to find out whether is there any combinations of two non-touching loops or not. Okay, so let's look at this graph. And what is the definition of non-touching loops? Loops, two loops, and they will not have any common node. So from this, very easily we can identify this loop as well as, you see this loop and this loop. These two loops are not non-touching. They touch each other. Why? This node is common, this node is common, this node is common. Okay. But look at this particular loop and this self loop. Do they have any common node?
No, ma'am.
So we find one combination of two non-touching loops, that is this loop and this loop. Any other, any second possibility?
Ma'am, x2, x3, x4, x2 and x3, x4, x5, x6.
Could you please repeat?
x2, x3, x4.
x2, x3, x4.
And x2. And the other loop is
x2.
Means that. And x3, x4, x5, x3.
x3, x4, x5, x3.
x3.
X3, X4, X5, X3. This is not a loop. Look at this. We have not identified this one to be a loop. X3, we are moving in this direction. X3 to X4, then we are moving to X5 along the direction of branch arrow.
Yes,
but
yes.
If I try to move in this direction, then I'm moving against the direction of branch arrow, and which is not permitted. So
yes,
this
yes.
one is not at all a loop. And you see, we have not considered this to be a loop at all, isn't it?
Yes, yes, I missed.
So, any other combination?
Ma'am. Ma'am, if we consider a loop x2, x3, x5 and then x2, then
yes,
this might
have
be
you
a...
Have you considered that to be a loop? That's my question.
No, ma'am.
x2 to x3, then to x5.
Then to x2.
And then x2.
Then x2. You have not considered this to be a single loop, isn't it?
Okay, ma'am.
But no, it's not okay. It's not okay. The thing is, you have already identified five loops.
Yes, ma'am.
So that means, since you have not considered this to be a loop, that means the loops that you have considered so far, among those, one loop should not be a valid loop. Try to identify it. Have you considered this loop to be a valid loop? Then you are wrong. Please check. Can you follow what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, loop two and no, ma'am. Loop one.
And... loop gula abar bolo. Loop one ki chilo bolo.
Loop one ওইটা ছিল ম্যাম
x1
x2
x3
x2 x2 যেটা
ওইটা দিস ইজ আ ভ্যালিড লুপ ওকে আই এগ্রি দিস ইজ আ ভ্যালিড লুপ হুইচ ওয়ান ওয়াজ দ্য সেকেন্ড লুপ দ্যাট ইউ হ্যাভ কনসিডারড আই গেস দিস ওয়ান
x3
x2 x3 x4 then x2 you see I'm moving along the branch direction in the direction of branch arrows and I'm coming back to this point so this is a valid loop and the loop gate will be a23 into a34 and into a42
yes ma'am
this one is a simple loop which can be easily identified with a loop gain a44 next তোমরা যেটা করেছো সেটা বলো
x3 x4 x5 x3
this is not a loop
yes ma'am this is not a loop
আমি আগেও একবার হিন্ট দিয়েছি আমি এমফ্যাটিক্যালি তখন বলিনি যাতে তোমরা নিজেরা করতে গিয়ে বুঝতে পারো ইউ সি আই এম মুভিং ইন দিস ডিরেকশন অ্যালং দ্য ডিরেকশন অফ ব্রাঞ্চ অ্যারো ফ্রম x3 টু x4 দ্যাট ইজ পারমিটেড দেন ফ্রম x4 টু x5 I'm moving along the direction of branch arrow. That is permitted. But I can't move in this direction. Signal can't flow in this direction. Signal flow will take place from X3 to X5 only. Am I clear? So though it seems to be a loop, but it's not a valid loop. Please note. Instead, the loop that you have missed out is x2 to x3, then along this path to x5, then again along this path back to x2. Please do the needful correction. Is this clear? Now is it clear? Absolutely clear.
Yes, ma'am.
So in that case, you see, when we are trying to identify the second combination of two non-touching loops, then this loop, that is x2 to x3 to x5 to x2, this loop and this self loop, they don't have any common node. So two non-touching loops, two combinations are there. One is this one, and this one, the other one is this one and this one. Clear?
Clear, ma'am.
So while calculating the determinant, we'll have to find out the loop gain or gain products of the two loops which are non-touching in nature. So for the first combination, the gain product will be A23 into A32 multiplied by the loop gain of this loop, that is A44. So P12, first possibility with two non-touching loops, or L12, whatever, will be A23 into A32 into A44. And the gain product of two non-touching loops, the second possibility, that is P22, second possibility, two non-touching loops, will be the gain, loop gain of this loop multiplied by the loop gain of this loop, So that will be A23 into A35 into A52 into A44. Done. अच्छा अच्छा
यस मैम
ओके सो
Ma'am, we are getting two types of non-touching loops, right?
Two combinations of type now. Two combinations of two non-touching loops. Three non-touching loops. Can you identify three loops in this graph? Can you identify three loops which do not have any common node? Can you identify three loops which do
no
not
loop.
Have no? That means three non-touching loops are not present in this signal flow graph. So that means now we are in a position to calculate the determinant of the graph delta, and but we cannot. Find out the transfer function because we don't know the values of delta k's. So in this case, two delta k value k value can assume or k can assume two values. One is one and the second one is two because there are two forward paths. Clear? Pk into delta k. Pk into delta k. So Pk is the k number of forward paths and delta k are the determinants of the portion of the graph which does not touch the kth forward path. Clear? So if I expand for this graph, okay, let me show you. So for this signal flow graph, if I expand the numerator, it will be P1 into delta 1 plus P2 into delta 2. And the transfer function of this graph will be equal to P1 into delta 1 plus P2 into delta 2 whole divided by this delta. Okay, so now we'll have to find out delta 1 and delta 2. So what is delta 1? Delta 1 is the determinant of that portion of the graph which does not touch the kth forward path. In this case, touching actually implies the same condition. That means a portion of the graph which will not have any common node present in the first forward path. Am I clear?
Clear, ma'am.
Okay. So look at this graph and try to find out whether is there any portion of the graph which does not touch the first forward path. Already we have identified the first forward path, and this is our first forward path, and path consists of the nodes x1, x2, x3, x4, x5 and x5. So is there any portion of the graph which does not touch?
No.
So what will be the value of delta 1?
1.
Yes, 1. Why delta 1 will be 1? Let me explain. Delta is equal to 1 minus summation of this individual loop gains of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops. So no individual loops. So this term will be 0. This term will be 0. All these terms will be zeros. Only this one will remain present. Hence, delta one in this case will be simply one. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, P2, the second forward path. Which one was the second forward path? X1 to X2 to X3 and then along this path to X5. So is there any portion of the graph which does not touch the second forward path?
A44, that loop.
Only this single loop. Don't use the term self loop, because in this case it's a self loop. For some other signal flow graph, this could may not be a self loop. Okay. So in this case, it's a self loop, right? So this portion of the graph, let's stick to this term. This portion of the graph does not touch the second forward path. And in this portion, we can identify one single loop only. So what will be the value of delta 2? The value of delta 2 will be equal to 1 minus one single loop whose loop gain is A44. And no other loops. No question of existence of two non-touching loops, right? So delta 2 will be 1 minus A44. Is it clear?
Clear.
Okay, let's see. So almost we have obtained the transfer function for this graph. Okay, sorry. So please check whether these are the path gains that you have calculated, that you have identified or not. This is the first forward path. There are two forward paths and the path gains are like this. P1, A12, A23, A34, A45. P2, A12, A23, A35. Just check. We have done this. We have solved this example. Right? Now there are five individual loops with loop gains P11. First loop, and we are considering one single loop. 11. So P11. A23 into A52, P21, the second individual loop, the second individual loop gain, A23 into A34 into A42, P31, the third individual loop gain is the loop A44, the fourth individual loop gain is a2 3 into a3 4 into a4 5 into a5 2 and p5 1, that is the loop gain of the fifth individual loop is a2 3 into a3 5 into a5 2. Please check whether you have obtained the correct loop gains or not. Done. Just Milia now.
ঠিক আছে ম্যাম।
Next, there are two possible combinations of two non-touching loops with loop gain P12. First combination, two non-touching loops. Okay, so A23, A32, A45, A44, and P22, second combination, two non-touching loops. A23, A35, A52, A44. And there are no combinations of three non-touching loops. Naturally, four non-touching loops could not be found, cannot be found in this, or will not be found in this particular graph. So PM3, PM4, all these terms are zero, right? So now, what will be the value of the determinant of the graph? 1 minus sum of Ashbina. Tomra nijeder sathe ye miliye nao. 1 minus sum of the loop gains of all individual loops. So we have 5 loops and these are the loop gains. This is the loop gain of the first individual loop. This is the loop gain of the second individual loop, third individual loop, fourth one, and the fifth one. Then the sum will be changed and it will be a plus sign. Then sum of the loop gains of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops. And these are the loop gains of two possible, two combinations of two non-touching loops. So the loop gains are A23, A32, this one, A23, A32, A44, plus A23, A35, A52, A44. And the rest of the term, rest of the terms will be zero. Now, already we have checked that the first forward path is in touch with all the loops. Therefore, delta 1 will be equal to 1. The second forward path is not in touch with one loop, as already we have identified. Therefore, delta 2 will be, delta 2 will be equal to 1 minus A44. And hence the transfer function or the gain of this graph, of this signal flow graph, is given, will be given by T is equal to X5 by X1. And that is equal to P1 into delta 1 plus P2 into delta 2 by delta. So now you substitute the value of P1 that you have obtained. Substitute the value of delta 1, that of delta P2, that of delta 2, and that of delta. and you will get the transfer function of the system. Have you understood Mason's gain formula? How to apply Mason's gain formula? The first thing is you'll have to understand Mason's gain formula, and then you'll have to learn how to apply Mason's gain formula for a given signal flow graph. Have you understood? Please do respond.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So your assignment is now you know how to construct a signal flow graph. So convert this block diagram, the original one, the first one, convert this block diagram into a signal flow graph. Then apply Mason's gain formula and find out the transfer function delta Q2S by delta QS, and also verify whether the transfer function is same as the transfer function that we have derived using block diagram reduction technique or not. That is this one. So for this block diagram, you draw the signal flow graph. If a block diagram is a very complicated one, then generally we don't go for block diagram reduction technique. What we do, we construct the corresponding signal flow graph, and then we apply Mason's gain formula to find out the transfer function of the overall system. Do you have any question? Any question? If you don't have any doubt or any question, then I'll close the file.
যেটা ছিল না ওইখানে যে ইকুয়েশনটাকে তো আমরা একটা জাস্ট সিঙ্গেল ইকুয়েশনও আনতে পারতাম, মানে ওই x4 is equal to a34x3 plus
এখানে যেখানে দেখানো হয়েছে যে x4 ক্যান অলসো ডিপেন্ড অন ইটস ওন ভ্যালু, ওই সেলফ লুপের ইন্ট্রোডাকশনটা দেওয়ার জন্য, কনসেপ্টটা দেওয়ার জন্য দেখানো হয়েছে x4 is some k1 into x3 plus some k2 into x4. বোঝাতে পারলাম? ওই জন্য স্পেসিফিক্যালি এই এক্সাম্পলটা নেওয়া হয়েছে। Any other doubt?